Hello everyone, today let us understand the ball poem composed by John Berryman. John Berryman is an American poet. He is best known for the collection of his poems, The Dream Songs. Before beginning, let me tell you this poem is a philosophical poem. Or we can say the tone of the poem is philosophical. There can be other tones according to the subject matter. For example, poems can be of critical tone, satirical, didactic, admiring or humorous also. Now let us see the introduction. A boy loses a ball. He is very upset. Boy has lost the ball. He is very upset. A ball doesn't cost much. It's not very costly. Nor is it difficult to buy another ball. Why then is the boy so upset? This is a million-dollar question. Why is the boy upset when he can buy another ball? Let's see. What is the boy now? Who has lost his ball? What is he to do? I saw it go merrily bouncing down the street and then merrily over. There it is in the water. What is the boy now? What is the condition of the boy? What is his state of mind? What is he thinking? Who has lost his ball? What is he to do? What is he going to do? What will be his reaction? I saw it go. Poet has seen it going. How it went away from the boy. He might be standing at a distance. And he might have seen the boy playing with the ball. He also saw when it went away. Merrily bouncing. It went away bouncing, jumping up and down. And it looked very happy to the poet. Merrily means happily. It doesn't affect ball where it has gone. It was happy when it was in hand of boy. It is still happy. It has gone away. So, it has gone down the street. After crossing the street and then merrily over, happily it went. There it is in the water. In the water. In some water body. At the bank of which the boy was playing. It can be sea. It can be river. No use to say, oh, there are other balls. Poet knows that it will be useless to tell him that there are other balls. He can buy other balls. Why he knows that it will be useless to say? Because an ultimate shaking grief fixes the boy. Complete grief, which has shaken him from inside. It has fixed the boy to the place where he is standing. Boy is fixed there. He is not moving. As he stands rigid, he is standing rigid, still, stiff. He is not moving. He doesn't want to move away. And he is trembling, shaking due to grief. He is staring down at the place where he is standing. Why he is staring fixedly? Because all his young days into the harbor where his ball went. All his young days have gone into the harbor. Harbor is a place where the boats or the ships stand while they are not moving. So his young days are symbolic. They are the symbol of his childhood memories, which were associated with the ball. And it has gone into harbor, near the water body. His ball went. I would not intrude on him. Intrude means going to a place where you are not welcome. Where you are not allowed or permitted or invited. So the poet knows that he will not be welcome. Boy will not like his consolation. Boy is in grieved. If the poet gives him a dime or another ball, it will be useless. That is why he doesn't want to intrude, to go to boy, because he knows he is not welcome. Boy will not like. Dime is a coin which is equal to 10 cents. He will also not give another ball because it is useless. Another ball cannot take place of the ball which he has lost. That ball is his favorite toy. He must have played with it for many days. There are moments, there are memories attached with the ball. That is why another ball will not give him that sense of belongingness. What that ball was giving. That is why it is worthless. Now he senses his first responsibility. So this word first responsibility tells that first time he is experiencing the loss. This is his first loss maybe in life. And after that first loss, there comes first responsibility to understand in a world of possessions. This world is a world of possessions. Full of possessions, full of things which we possess, which we own, which we get, which we achieve. It can be any toy, anything which we buy, any loved relations, your job, money, property, fame, success, anything. So these possessions are there in the world. People will take balls and balls will be lost. Here the ball doesn't mean that ball with which we play. Here ball means possessions. In childhood, we feel sad about balls. When we grow up, we feel sad when we lose some loved one. We feel sad when we lose our job or any other thing. So people will get the things and those things will be lost. We cannot keep crying over the things. That is why it is our responsibility to understand that this world is full of possessions. We will get the things and those things will be lost. This is the reality of life. Little boy, and no one buys a ball back. It means we cannot buy a ball back which is lost. That's why you can buy another ball, but the same ball or same thing which is lost, you cannot buy back with money, because money is external. Money can only buy material things, but the emotions which are attached with the ball, the memories, the sense of belongingness cannot be bought by money. That is why money is external. Money can only buy material things. And he is learning. Boy is learning now. How does the poet know? Poet knows because he has seen that well behind his desperate eyes. Now his eyes are desperate over the loss. Still he is learning. Because he understands that the thing which is lost will not be got again. He is learning the epistemology of loss. Epistemology comes from the word episteme, which is taken from Greek language and it means knowledge, learning. And he is learning the epistemology of loss, how to stand up. How to face, how to bear the loss, how to stand up against the loss. After knowing what every man must one day know, every man has to understand this, that loss is inevitable. We cannot avoid loss. If we get a thing, it has to be lost. So we have to be brave, strong, and face the loss and other hardships in life, everyone has to know one day. Most people know this thing after many days. How to stand up, how to face, how to bear the loss. So the poem conveys that we have to face and bear the loss. This is an extract. The poem is a little longer and it conveys that we have to be wise in our life and we have to see the reality of life. Now let's see the poetic devices used in the poem. First of all, let me tell you, there is an aphora, repetition of a word in two consecutive line. The beginning of two consecutive line is known as an aphora. Merrily bouncing, merrily over. Here also the word merrily is repeated in the beginning of next two consecutive line. Consecutive means coming one after the first line. So this is an aphora. Now we have alliteration. Alliteration is very simple. Repetition of a consonant in the beginning of a word. Here we can see repetition of sound M. We have to see that consonants sound should be there. Same consonant sound is repeated. There we have alliteration. In the next line, repetition of B sound. Buys a ball back. This is alliteration. And then we have assonance. Assonance is the repetition of vowel sound. A, E, I, O, U. If their sounds are repeated, we have assonance. So this is epistemology of loss. O, O. In a world of possessions, repetition of O sound at a particular place. What is he to do? Same O sound is repeated. Then imagery is about giving a picture, describing a thing which is like a picture, which appeals to your senses. Merrily bouncing down the street. This appeals to our sense of sight. Ball which is bouncing up and down and it looks happy. So this is imagery. Repetition is simple repetition. Repetition of a word. What? Repetition of what? Repetition of balls. Repetition of a word in same line is known as repetition. Symbolism. All his young days. Young days is a symbol for his memories. Days have not gone. Memories have gone. So this is symbolism. Now let's see some important questions quickly. What does the poet want to convey through the poem? The wall poem. John Berryman wants to convey the significance of loss in our life, which I have explained to you. He teaches how to cope up with the loss. Experiencing loss helps to grow up and face hardships. If we experience loss, it helps us grow and face hardships. The poet makes the boy understand his responsibility when he loses his ball. As the loss is inevitable, unavoidable, one needs to accept the loss as a part of life, no matter how much it hurts. Life must go on. Life is to be lived and not wasted mourning over the loss which is past and clinging to something which is lost, just like the boy who was trembling with grief. They don't want to lose the thing. That is called clinging. Trembling with the grief. When the ball went into the harbor, he felt that all his childhood memories were lost. But the poet wants the boy to learn the epistemology of loss and understand that the past is gone. and he should move on, because life is to be lived and will never come back. Staying strong is the only way to survive. Hence, it is important for everyone to experience loss, to stand up after it and to get on with life. What does the poet mean when he says money is external? Money is termed as external in terms of the loss, which is immaterial, which is not material. Money is external as it cannot buy memories. It can buy material things such as toys, gifts, houses, vehicles. It can't buy lost childhood, lost memories, lost relations, nor can it replace the things that we love and the things that really matter in our life. If such things are lost, they can't be bought back. That is why money is external. Money is external to such losses. I hope you understand. If the theme or the message of the poem is asked, this material only you can mold and present it according to in the language of the question. If you have any difficulty, if you have any questions which you do not find how to answer, you can ask those questions in the comment box. I will try to answer each question. Thank you. Keep watching my channel and like my videos. All the best for your exams.